what is integumentary system is the coverings of our body. So the three things will cover our body usually: skin, hair, and nails. So these are the three things which helps for the protection for our body. So here is the picture with the cross section of skin and the hair follicles and the three layers of the skin. So this layer we call it as epidermis. So whatever we touch, whatever we see, that outermost skin layer is epidermis. And this layer is dermis. And below the dermis, we have the fatty layer, which is hypodermis. Hypodermis or subcutaneous layer. Here only the fat is stored. And coming to the next, functions of integumentary system. So usually integumentary system will works as a protective mechanism. So it will protect the body from the things should not enter from outside to inside, or the fluid should not escape from inside the body to outside. So it acts like a two-way protective barrier. And for temperature regulation, our temperature is mainly controlled by our skin. For example, when it was on a sunny day, so our skin will sweat. So it will cool down the body with the help of production of sweat. At the same time, when we are during the cold climate, just a moment. Okay. So at the same time, when we are during the cold climate, our skin will get shivering. So that's how the heat is generated during the cold climate. So in two ways, when in the sunny region as well as in the cold climate. So in the both temperatures, our skin will be helpful in maintaining the temperature. And how's for sensory receptors? The sensory receptors are touch, temperature, pain, and pressure. In the touch also, we have light touch and crude touch. So all these sensations are being located on the skin. And also it secretes the very important fluids such as sweat and sebaceous glands. Sweat will control the body temperature. By producing the sweat, it cools down the body. At the same time, sebaceous glands will secrete the oily secretions. We call that as sebum. And coming to the organs of integumentary system, skin, hair, nails, subcutaneous glands, and sweat glands. These are all the organs of integumentary system. So let's see the combining forms. Albino. Albino means white. So usually, losing the melanin, we call it as albinism. So we also have, usually the disease, we call it as vitiligo. Vitiligo means losing the melanin. So that white color thing is albino. So usually we can see albino type of things in animals. So albino peacock, albino tiger, albino lion. So these will lose the skin pigmentation. And bio is life. Cryo means cold. So cryotherapy, with the use of cold, they'll do the therapy. Cutaneous means skin. So cutaneous, dermo is skin. Cyano means blue. So we have a condition called cyanosis. Blue is discoloration of the body. And dermo is skin. And dermato is also skin. Dermo or dermato, both are skin only. Dyphoro means profuse sweating. Or more sweating. Electro means electricity. Erythro is red. So hydro means sweating. So for some people, they'll have a abnormal condition of more sweat production. That we call it as hydrosis. Or for some people, they'll not get sweat out of the body. So that we call it as anhydrosis. Ichthyo means dryness or scaliness. We call it as ichthyo. And next, Kerato. Kerato is hard or horny. So that's why we call it as keratin, the outer layer of the eyeball. Cornea is made up of the tissue called keratin. And Leuco is white. Lipo means fat. Melano, black. So melanocyte means black cell. Melanin is the black pigment. Myco is fungus. So if anywhere, if you get the word myco, means that means fungus. Usually in the drugs and ointments also, you will get the word called mycin. mycetes that will kill the fungus. So, and next, necro. Necro is death. Necrosis, abnormal death of the tissues or cells. Onycho, onycho means nail. Pilo, pilo means hair. So, for example, piloerection, we call it as goosebumps. So, goosebumps, medical terminology is piloerection. Photo, photo means light. Pio, pio is pus. And rightido, rightido means wrinkles. Sclero, which is hard. SIBO is oil. So, sebaceous glands means oil secreting glands. Trico means hair. Trichology, study of hair. Ungo, ungo or onycho, both means nail only. Vesico, vesico means bladder. Zero, zero means dry. Next, coming to the suffixes, derma, derma is skin. Opsy, opsy means to view. So any instrument which is used to view inside the body, we call it as opsy. And tome, tome means instrument used to cut. So any the instrument used to cut any body part, for that you will get a suffix called tome. Allo, allo means other or different from usual. So usually we use this words near the grafting, allograft. And xeno, xeno means foreign or strange. So not the human thing, it may be from the animals, that we call it as xeno. So let's see the anatomy and physiology part. So this is the skin. So in the skin we have three layers: epidermis, dermis, hypodermis or subcutaneous layer. And in the skin, we have the accessory organs. So that is sweat glands, sebaceous glands, hairs, hair and nails. And we'll see the clear picture about the skin. This is epidermis. So usually the dead cells will be coming continuously on this top layer, because the epidermis will continuously reproduce the cells and pushes the older cells on the upwards. And that older cells will die, and continuously it will be removed. And this layer we call it as dermis. Dermis or chorion, which means true skin. So inside this dermis, we have many things like blood supply. So which is highly vascular in nature. Highly vascular means it has arterial supply, venous drainage, lymphatic drainage, and at the same time, it has the sweat glands, sebaceous glands and hair. So all these things are located in the dermis. And the lower and the below this layer, we call it a subcutaneous layer or hypodermis. So which consists of fatty cells. So in the fatty cells, the fat will get deposited. And let's see the, in detail. It's coming to the skin. Skin is the largest organ in the body. It weighs more than 20 pounds in adults, means around 1.5 to 1.6 kgs. Skin is also called integument. Integument means covering, or cutaneous membrane. So coming to the functions, the same thing what we have studied priorly, protection, house for nerve receptors such as touch, temperature, pain, pressure, light touch, crude touch, and it secretes the fluids, sweat and sebum. And it helps in regulating the temperature by producing the sweat and for with shivering. Protection. How it, the protection takes place is, it acts like a two-way barrier. It keeps out the pathogens and harmful substances and prevents the critical body fluids from escaping. The critical body fluids are blood, tissue fluid, lymph. So these are the critical body fluids. And protects the underlying tissue. So usually the skin will store fat in the hypodermis layer. So why do the fat storage will be there is, so it helps to protection for the underlying organs. That's how we store the fat. And sensory receptors. The sensory receptors are mainly located in the middle layer only. So that dermis or chorion. So that helps to detect the temperature, pain, pressure and touch. So the nerve endings usually will convey the messages to the spinal cord and brain. So the fluids produced are sweat and oil. So sweat is produced from sweat glands. So the sweat glands are located in the dermis layer. And it assists for maintaining the internal body temperature also. So by producing the sweat, it cools the body. And sebaceous glands. So sebaceous glands will produce the fluid called sebum. So that was usually oil glands. Sebaceous glands or oil glands. That will lubricate the skin surface. And temperature regulation. How it controls the temperature is, first one, to cool the skin. So to cool the skin, the sweat will be produced and the sweat evaporates. And also, it will increase the superficial blood vessels diameter. And through that, it will release the excess amount of heat from the body. This will be very commonly happens during summer season. And next, during winter season and during cold climates. So to conserve the heat, what it will do to conserve the heat is quite opposite thing. So it will decrease the diameter of blood vessels to keep the blood warm. And the continuous fat layer will give the insulation, so to protect from the cold. So this was the thing happened during summers. So the diameter of the blood vessel will get increases. So that's how the excess amount of heat from the body is being taken away. And this happens during cold. So this will constrict the blood vessels. So that's how the temperature is being preserved. Because we are homeothermic. Homeothermic means our body temperature will be always 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. Wherever we are and whatever the season is, our body temperature is 98.6. So that was the core body temperature. So that will be maintained. So the maintenance will be by sweat production during summer and by shivering or constriction of blood vessels during winter. And the skin. So it has three layers. Epidermis, which is the outermost membrane. Dermis, the middle, and it is fibrous connective tissue layer. And the subcutaneous layer, which is the innermost layer, which contains lipocytes. So the lipocytes will store the fats. So next, epidermis. Epidermis is made up of stratified squamous epithelium. So the stratification means it was made up of different layers. We have the basement membrane and we have the living cells and dead cells. So likewise, the differentiation will be there. So the differentiation means stratification. And squamous. Squamous means flat in nature. So all the cells are arranged in flat. So that's how we call it as squamous. Epithelium means that will be covering the organs. So that's how we call it as epithelium. So flat scale-like cells arranging in an overlapping manner called strata. And there is no much blood supply for epidermis. It will depend on that basal layer for blood. And this was the photomicrograph image of epidermis. So this was the basement membrane. And we can see many different layers here. This layering, we call it as stratification. And the cells are flat arranged, flat scale-like arrangement. So that's how we call it a squamous. And basal layer of the epidermis. The basal layer of the cells will continuously, so this was the basal layer. It will continuously reproduce the cells and push the older cells upwards. So here the cells will die and that will be continuously replaced by the bottom layer. And usually the cells will shrink, die and fill with the hard protein, which we call it as keratin. So the cells are keratinized. So that's how it acts as a barrier to prevent infections. And melanocytes. Melanocytes are special cells in the basal layer. So that will produce the black pigment called melanin. So that gives the skin color. So usually the skin is darker in color to protect the skin from ultraviolet radiation and infrared radiation. So usually when you go into the sun, we wear the goggles. So usually the goggles are having UV protection or infrared protection because it was been putting a black layer. So that layer will usually protect us. So the same thing. And dermis layer. Dermis layer, we also call it as corium. it was located between epidermis and hypodermis or subcutaneous. So dermis, we also call it as corium. Corium or true skin. So it's the living tissue with very good blood supply. But for the epidermis, we don't have the blood supply. It will be dependent on the dermis. So dermis is composed of collagen fibers. So epidermis is composed of keratin. Dermis is composed of collagen. Because of the collagen only, it was flexible in nature. And the dermis will be hosting the hair follicles, sweat glands, sebaceous glands, blood vessels, lymph vessels, sensory receptors, nerve fibers, muscle fibers. All these things will be there in the dermis. And subcutaneous layer, which is the very bottom layer of the skin, we also call it as hypodermis. Hypo means below, dermis means skin. It was composed of lipocytes, means fat storing cells. And it protects the deeper tissues of the body. And it acts as an insulation for heat and cold. And coming to the accessory organs, hair, nails, and sweat glands and sebaceous glands. So we'll see about the hair. In the hair, we have these four parts. Hair follicle, hair root, hair shaft. And we have a muscle called erector pili muscle. So this was erector pili muscle. Because of this muscle only, the goosebumps will be possible. We call it as piloerection, nothing but standing of hair. So the hair will be grows longer from the roots only. So always the root has to be stronger, then only the hair will grow. So the deeper cells of the hair will push the older cells, just like epidermis. So at the root hair, the growth will be starting. So it will push the deeper layers to upwards. And coming to the next thing. And this forms the hair shaft, which grows towards the surface with hair follicles. And melanin gives the hair its color. So our hair is black in color because of the melanin. And coming to the next, erector pili. So the slip of the smooth muscle, which causes the hair to stand up. And here, just a moment. So this is the hair shaft. And the sebaceous glands will be always associated with the hair. And this is erector pili muscle. This is hair follicle. And this is hair bulge, we call it as. And this is hair bulb. And this is hair papillae. And here we have the capillaries. Capillaries are nothing but smaller blood vessels. So here is the picture about the hair follicle and its parts. And coming to the nail. So in the nail, we have certain parts. So this we call it as nail body. So this is nail body. So which is a plate of keratin. And this we call it as nail bed. Nail body, nail bed. And lunula. Lunula was the half moon shaped area present at the base of the nail. So you can see from in this picture. This is nail body. And this is nail bed. And here we have the lunula, half moon shaped white color region. And this we call it as cuticle. So this is cuticle. And the embedded nail, we call it as nail root. And this is free edge. So usually we cut the free edge. So again, you can see in this picture, this is free edge. So we cut the nails at the free edge only. And this is nail body. And this is nail bed. And this is cuticle and lunula. And below the nail, we have this adipose tissue. And this is nail root. And sebaceous glands. Sebaceous glands will open into hair follicles. So because of that only, the hair will be shiny. And it secretes oil. We call it as sebum. That lubricates the hair and skin and prevents from drying and cracking. And sweat glands. Sweat glands, we also call it as sub-auriferous glands. Sub-auriferous glands because this ori means this opening. This opening will lies on the epidermis. That's why we call it as sub-auriferous gland. and it was coiled in the dermis. This gland was coiled in the dermis, and this tubular extension we call it as sweat duct, and this opening we call it as sweat pore. So the sweat will be produced in the gland and it will move through the sweat duct and it will come out through the sweat pore. And there are around 2 million of sweat glands throughout the body. And it produces the sweat. We also call it as perspiration. And cools the body as it evaporates. And contains a small amount of waste products. Normally, it was colorless and odorless. And coming to the next, apocrine glands. It was found in the pubic or in the underarm areas. So the thicker sweat can produce the odor. So usually, the normal sweat will not have the odor except the glands present in the underarms and the pubic area. So coming to the word building part, subcutaneous means related to under the skin. Epidermal, related or pertaining to upon skin. Epi means upon, dermis is skin. Hypodermic, hypo means under, dermic is skin. And next, intradermal. Usually certain injections are given intradermally. So for example, insulin. Insulin injection is given intradermally within the skin. Dermatitis, inflammation of the skin. Dermatologist, skin specialist. Dermatosis, any abnormal condition or any skin disease, we call it as dermatosis. And dermatopathy, skin disease. Dermatoplasty. Plasty means surgical repair. So surgical repair of the skin. Anhidrosis. Hidrosis means sweat production. Anhidrosis, which is an abnormal condition of no sweat production. Hyperhidrosis, abnormal condition with excessive sweat production. Lipectomy, surgically removing of the fat. Lipoma, which means fat tumor. And melanoma, which is black tumor. And melanocyte. Melanocyte means black cell. And necrosis, abnormal condition of tissue or cell death. Onychectomy. Onycho means nail and ectomy is surgical removal. Surgical removing of the nail. Onychomalacia. Malacia means softening. So onychomalacia means nail softening. Onychomycosis. Myco means fungal infection. So onychomycosis means abnormal fungal infection to the nail. Onychophagia, we call it as nail biting or nail eating. So many people will have a habit of nail biting or nail eating. So usually they won't use this nail cutters on them. They biting the nail only, they'll remove the nails. Pyogenic, which is pus production. Rhytidectomy, surgical removal of wrinkles. Rhytidoplasty, surgical repair of the wrinkles. And seborrhea, abnormal oil discharge. Trichomycosis, abnormal condition with hair fungus. Ungual, pertaining or related to nails. And erythroderma, erythro means red, derma is skin. So red skin. Ichthyoderma. Ichthyo means dry or scaly. Scaly or dry skin. Leucoderma, which is white skin. And pyoderma, pus skin. Scleroderma, hard skin. And next, xeroderma, which is dry skin. Yeah. This is all about the word building. And the first, anatomy and physiology about the integumentary system. Tomorrow we'll see about the vocabulary, pathology and diagnostic procedures and skin grafting.